Good morning, children.
Today we continue chapter 9, data handling. Last class we learned how a pictograph represents data in the form of pictures, objects or parts of objects. We have also seen how to interpret a pictograph and answer the related questions.
Today we can learn how to draw pictographs using symbols to represent a certain number of items or things by doing questions from exercise 9.2.
First question. Total number of animals in 5 villages are as follows. Village A 80, Village B 120, Village C 90, Village D 40, Village E 60. Our question is, prepare a pictograph of these animals using one symbol to represent 10 animals and answer the following questions. For that, first we draw a table like this. And this table has two columns. And first column containing villages, name of these villages. And in the second column, number of animals. Now consider the question. In first village, there are 80 animals. So, in first column, we write name of village, village A. And corresponding second column, we draw this symbol for 80, indicating 80. We know that this one symbol is representing 10 animals. But in village A, there are 80 animals. So, how many symbols you draw? Yes, 8 symbols we draw. So, 1, now 10, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, there are 8 symbols and each representing 10 animals. So, altogether 80 we get. That is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. So, we can say that village A has 80 animals. So, in the table above, we write the symbol is equal to 10 animals. Then only we can identify. Next, write village B. In village B, there are 120 animals. So, we draw 12 symbols because each symbol representing 10 animals. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Next, village C. In village C, there are 90 animals. So we draw 9 symbols. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Now village D that has 40 animals. So we draw 4 symbols corresponding to village D. Next, consider village E. Village E, there are 60 animals. So, we draw 6 symbols corresponding to village E. Now look at the questions. First question, How many symbols represent animals of village A? So here there are 6 symbols. So answer is 6. Next question. Which village has maximum number of animals? It is clear from the table that this village B has maximum number of animals. That is 120 animals in that village. So our answer is village B. Next question C. Which village has more animals? Village A or village C? We can see that village A has 80 animals and village C has 90 animals. So village C has more animals than village A. So our answer is village C. Second question. Total number of students of a school in different years is as shown in the following table. First years and second column number of students. 1996 400 students, 1998 535, 2472, 2002 600, 2004 623. First question. Prepare a pictograph of students using one symbol to represent 100 students and answer the following questions. Question A. How many symbols represent total number of students in the year 2002? To draw the pictograph, first we draw a table like this. And in this table there are 2 columns. First column indicating year and second column indicating number of students. And above that table you write the symbol representing 100 students. Now we can start drawing. Consider the year 1996. 1996 there are 400 students. So first column we write year 1996. And second column we draw the symbol representing 400 students. We know that one symbol representing 100 students. So in order to represent 400 students we draw 4 symbols. 1, 2, 3, 4. Since each representing 100 students, we get 1996 there are 400 students. Next, 1998. Here there are 535 students. So first we draw one symbol, now 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 and 135 also is there. So we draw one incomplete picture also because here only 35, not 100 students. So we draw the symbol as incomplete. Next, consider the year 2000. In the year 2000, there are 472 students. So first we draw 4 complete symbols. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And 4 indicating 72, we draw one incomplete symbol also. Next, consider the year 2002. In that year, there are 600 students. So, we draw 6 complete symbols. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Next, 2004. In that year there are 623 students. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 600 students and draw one incomplete for 23. So, in the year 2004, there are 623 students. Now, look at the question. Question A. How many symbols represent total number of students in the year 2002? We know that in 2002, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 symbols. So, 6 symbols representing the number of students in the year 2002. Next question. How many symbols represent total number of students for the year 1998? Look at the pictograph. Corresponding to year 1998, there are 5 complete symbols and 1 incomplete symbol. So, our answer is 5 complete and 1 incomplete.
Let us see another method of representing data, that is a bar diagram or a bar graph. Here, bars of uniform width can be drawn horizontally or vertically with equal spacing between them, and then the length of each bar represents the given number. Consider the example of a bar graph. Here, the horizontal line representing year and vertical line representing population in crores. Here, look at the graph. The bar corresponding to the year 1951 means population in that year is 38 crores. Again, bar corresponding to 1961 represents population in that year is 40 crores. Such a way we can find population in each year easily. Now we can interpret bar graph by solving exercise 9.3.
First question. The bar graph given alongside shows the amount of wheat purchased by government during the year 1998 to 2002. Read the bar graph and write down your observations. In which year was the wheat production maximum? Before answering these questions, first you look at the bar graph. Here, this horizontal line indicating years. Here, this is the year 1998, then 1999, 2000, 2001 and 2002. Next, this vertical line indicating wheat in 1000 tons. And we start from 0, then 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. This 5, 10, 15 means 1000 tons, 5000 tons, 10,000 tons, 15,000 tons, like that. And here also, one scale is given there, one unit length is equal to 5000 tons. That is 5, then 5 plus 5, 10, 10 plus 5, 15, like that. Now, look at the questions. The wheat production, in which year was the wheat production maximum? We know that the bar corresponding to 2002 is greater than while comparing other bars. So, in the year 2002, the wheat production is maximum. The wheat production is maximum in the year 2002. Next question, in which year was wheat production minimum? The bar corresponding to 1998 is smaller than the other bars. So, our answer is 1998. That is, the wheat production in the year 1998 is minimum. Next question. Observe this bar graph, which is showing the sale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday
to Saturday.
And here this line indicating, this vertical line indicating days and horizontal line indicating number of shirts sold. Now answer the following questions. Question A. What information does the above bar graph give? The above bar graph gives the sale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday to Saturday. So, our answer is
the sale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday to Saturday.
Question B. What is the scale chosen on the horizontal line representing number of shirts? As I already said, this is the scale representing number of shirts. That is, one unit length is equal to 5 shirts. Here, the scale is 5. That is 5, 10, 15, 20, like that. So, our answer is one unit length is equal to 5 shirts. Next question C. On which day were the maximum number of shirts sold? How many shirts were sold on that? Here, the bar corresponding to Saturday is longer than other days. So, Saturday, maximum shirts were sold. And number of shirts sold on that day is 60, because the bar ends above 60. So, our answer is 60. 60 shirts. Question D. On which day were the minimum number of shirts sold? Here, it is clear from the graph that the bar corresponding to Tuesday is shorter. So, our answer is Tuesday. Next question. How many shirts were sold on Thursday? Consider the bar corresponding to Thursday. Here this bar ends above 35. So our answer is 35. Next question 3. Observe this bar graph, which shows the marks obtained by Aziz in half yearly examination in different subjects. Answer the given questions. What information does the bar graph give? This bar graph gives the marks obtained by Aziz in half yearly examination. So our answer is
the bar graph shows the marks obtained by Aziz in half yearly examination in different subjects.
Next question B. Name the subject in which Aziz scored maximum marks. It is clear that the bar corresponding to Hindi is higher than other bars. So, our answer is Hindi. Next question. Name the subject in which he has scored minimum marks. Here, the bar corresponding to social science is the shortest one. So, our answer is social studies. Question D. State the name of subjects and marks obtained in each of them. First, consider Hindi. Hindi, there are 80 marks, because this bar ends near 80. So, the marks obtained in Hindi, 80. Next, consider marks obtained in English, that is 60. Next, marks obtained in mathematics, that is 70. Next, science, that is 50. Then social studies, that is 40.
Thank you, children.